One thing I will never understand about famous detectives like Hercule Poirot or Benoit Blanc is that they are constantly surrounded by death. So why on earth would you be so willing to share the same location or to associate with them in any way? I don't want to inadvertently end up in the crosshairs.
Everyone who ever lived here falls victim to some tragedy. Like her daughter a year ago.
My daughter was my whole life. To hear her voice again, I would give all I have.
How's it going, guys? Welcome back to my channel and time for another episode of Luke's Reviews. On today's video, Kenneth Branagh is back as the moustache detective as he is jetting off to yet another exotic location full of murder, mystery and intrigue, but this time round, a little spookiness thrown in the mix with a haunting in Venice. Living a quiet, retired life in Venice, famed investigator Hercule Poirot's piece is disrupted when he's invited by a friend to attend a party, followed later by a seance. At the gathering, Poirot comes across a multitude of names and faces, which draws to a head during the controversial seance. And when a body rocks up dead, Poirot begins his investigation. However, this time he'll have to endure possible hauntings, and whether he has an answer, or if something more ghostly is afoot. Murder mysteries, when done well, are deliriously entertaining. They keep you guessing as to who might be next, who the culprit is. It is simple entertainment. And of late, Kenneth Branagh has kind of made this his own fascination as he's developed what I'm dubbing the ACCU, that's the Agatha Christie Cinematic Universe. He's taken a trip aboard the Orient Express and he's witnessed a death on the Nile, but this time round, Branagh as Poirot is sending himself off with another talented ensemble to Venice. What's most startling to notice about A Haunting in Venice is just how remarkably different the direction is. Murder on the Orient Express and Death on the Nile were directed pretty much how you thought they would be. Conventionally told movies that tend to rely on the strength of Agatha Christie's story and the A-list ensemble that he's put together. This is the first of Branagh's Poirot adventures where the direction actually feels like the true star. Leaning into a gothic horror atmosphere, Branagh and director of photography Harris Sambalukos experiment with a plethora of Dutch angles and off-putting POV shots. It all feels fundamentally different to the previous mysteries that we've seen, and that in turn just makes it feel that more refreshing. In terms of performances, everyone is chewing the scenery here. They're all leaning into these eccentric characters at play. I mean, it's business as usual for Branagh's Poirot. You know, he's still got that thick Belgian accent. He's still got that equally thick moustache. But this time round, Poirot gets a real challenge to sink his teeth into, which was nice to see. Tina Fey also turns in a great performance as an excitable murder mystery author and a friend of Poirot's. I thought she did a really, really good job at giving off that 1940s, 1950s dame energy. Jamie Dornan and Michelle Yeoh are a touch underutilized, but I only say that because I know just what the pair of them are capable of. And also, I don't want to leave out young Jude Hill. He first came onto the scene with Branagh in Belfast, and I thought he was absolutely fantastic in this. And in A Haunting in Venice, he does it again. Hill has a real commanding presence where he needs to. I honestly think he's got a very bright future ahead of him. Now, as far as actual story is concerned, that's where A Haunting in Venice didn't impress all that much. It's elevated in a direction, especially in that first third, but by the time we reach the halfway mark, that's when we just jump on board with the traditional Agatha Christie conveyor belt. We split into rooms and we interrogate everyone, and there might be another murder or two, and before you know it, Hercule Poirot is giving his big dramatic monologue as he's outing the culprit, and that's the end of the movie. I know that it's a habit and ultimately to be expected, so you can't really punish the film all that much. But considering the direction was giving the film so much excitement and edge, it was a shame to not see the story match. Strong performances and a solid reminder as to how good of a director Kenneth Branagh is, A Haunting in Venice ticks a lot of the boxes you'd expect an Agatha Christie adaptation to tick, but also throws in a few scary curveballs too. I'm going to give A Haunting in Venice a 6.5 out of 10. Anyway, guys, those were my thoughts on A Haunting in Venice. Let me know, have you had a chance to see the film yet? What did you think? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. And my question to you, I would like to know, of all of Agatha Christie's stories, what one would you like to see Kenneth Branagh take a stab at next? But that's all the time we have for today, so thank you very much for watching. Make sure to like this video and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Hello, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have, make sure to click that like button, and if you aren't already, click that subscribe button too.